Hello friends, welcome to Techstudycell. In this video, we will make a IoT-based home automation system using the ESP32 to control the appliances with Google Assistant and Alexa. I have used all the free resources for this project, and also you don't need an Echo Dot or Google Home devices. You can just use their Android app to control these appliances with voice command. And during the video, I will share the circuit, code, and all other details. But before that, let me show you how it works. Hey Google, turn off all the lights.
Okay, turning off 3 lights.
Hey Google, turn on room light.
Got it, turning the room light on.
Alexa, turn on night lamp.
Okay.
Hey Google, turn on kitchen light.
Got it, turning the kitchen light on.
Now let me control the lamps with the manual switches. So today we are going to make this project, and I have just used a ESP32 and a relay module for this project, so you don't need any custom designed PCB. And as I said, I will share all the details during the video, so let's get started. For this project, you need a ESP32, a 4-channel relay module. You can use the existing switchboard, or you can also use the push button. I have already made a video using NodeMCU, so if you want to use NodeMCU instead of ESP32, then please refer my previous video. Now we have to connect all these components as per this circuit diagram. As you can see, the circuit is very simple. You have to give 5 volt supply to ESP32, and these switches are connected across the GPIO pins and the ground pin. If you want to use push button, then just connect the push button across the GPIO pin and the ground pin. But in this project, I am using the switch. And this is a AC circuit. This is live and this is neutral wire. Please take proper safety precaution while connecting these appliances with the relay module. You can see I have connected this ESP32 with these switches, and these are the GPIO pin from ESP32, and this is the common ground, and this is the relay module. Again, I have connected this with ESP32, and I will control these 4 AC lamps which are connected with the relay module. So this is the AC circuit and this is the DC circuit. Now before uploading the code, I have to configure the Sinric Pro account for this project. So you can click on the sign up and fill up all these details to create an account, but I have already an account, so I will tap on login and enter the registered mail ID and password. So this is the dashboard. First I have to create a room, so here I will click on add room and give the name, say living room. You can give any name. Now I will click on save. Our room is created. Now I'll go to devices, and here I will add 3 devices. So I will click on add device, give a name to this device. You can give any name, and device type will be switch, and I have selected the room as living room. Now I will click on next. Now if you want any push notification related to that device, then you can turn it on. You can also set the timer for that device from this window. Now here I will click on save. You can see the device added, and in similar way I will add next 2 devices. So I have added 3 devices, and each device has its own unique device ID which will be required in the code. Now we can program the ESP32 for this project. This is the code for this project. To download the code, visit our website iotcircuithub.com. I have shared the link of the article in the description. Then you can download the code from this button. Now before uploading the code, you have to download and install the ESP32 board, and then you need these 3 libraries. You can also visit this link. Here you can see they have mentioned all the dependency. So you need this Sinric Pro, Arduino JSON, and WebSocket libraries. After doing that, you have to enter your Wi-Fi credential. So here I will enter the Wi-Fi name and the Wi-Fi password. After that, you have to enter the app key and app secret. And to get the app key and app secret, you have to visit the Sinric Pro account and you have to go to credentials, and here you will find the app key and app secret. Just copy it. After that, I have to enter the device ID for each device. So again, I have to go to the Sinric account, then go to devices, and from here I can copy the device ID for the device. So let me paste it here. As I am using the free Sinric Pro account, so I can add maximum 3 devices for free. So we can control these 3 devices through internet, but we can control the 4 devices only from the manual switches. After that, you can see these are the GPIO pins I have used for this project. Now if you want to use the push button, then just uncomment this line. You can use the same code with push button. As I will use switches, so I will comment it. Now you can upload the code to ESP32. For that, I have to go to tools, select the board as do it ESP32 Devkit V1, then select the proper port, then I can hit the upload button. I have already made a video on how to download the libraries and program the ESP32 board. You can find the link of that video in the description. After uploading the code to ESP32, I have to connect the Sinric Pro account with the Google Home and Amazon Alexa app. So let me open the Google Home app. First, I have to create a home. So I will tap on this plus icon, then tap on create new home. Here you have to give a name for that home, say smart home. You can give any name, then select the address, then tap on continue. So the home is created. Now we will add device. So I will tap on this plus icon and select setup device. Now I will tap on works with Google. Here I have to search for Sinric Pro, then tap on the Sinric Pro. Now I have to log in to Sinric Pro account. So I will enter the email ID and password, then I will tap on sign in. Now I will go to main screen of the Google Home app, and you can see all the devices connected. So if I tap on the living room lights, here you can see these are the 3 lights we have added in the Sinric Pro account. Now I will quickly set up the Amazon Alexa app for this project. So let me open the Amazon Alexa app, and in the device you can see there is no device connected. First I will go to more. Then here I will select skills and games. After that I will search for Sinric Pro, then select the Sinric Pro. Now I will tap on enable to use. Again I have to log in to Sinric account, then I will tap on sign in, and here you can see your Sinric Pro account has been successfully linked, so I can close it. Now I have to tap on discover devices, and during this time the ESP32 should be connected with the Wi-Fi. And here you can see Alexa found 3 devices. So I will go to device, and in the plug you can see these are the 3 devices we have connected. So now we can control the appliances with the Google Assistant and Alexa app with the voice command. Let me show you. Here you can see our circuit is ready. Now let me give the supply. First let me control the appliances with the Google Assistant. Hey Google, turn on all the lights.
Okay, turning on 3 lights.
Hey Google, turn off night lamp.
Sure, turning the night lamp off.
Alexa, turn on the night lamp.
Okay.
So thus we can easily control it with the Google Assistant and Alexa. Let me control it from the manual switch. So this is a very useful IoT-based home automation project, and you can also join our Telegram channel Tech Study Cell to get different home automation ideas. So if you find this project helpful, please hit the like button and share it with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe for more such videos. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.